Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. From this class onwards, we are going to discuss JavaScript advanced concepts, friends. Okay, so till now, in the last tutorials, what we did is, we had learned the basic programming language of JavaScript, right? And from these classes, we are going to discuss JavaScript advanced concepts by making use of those fundamentals, JavaScript basic fundamentals. We are going to build up some concepts, right? So let us dive into the topic. So OOPS concept, right? So OOPS means object oriented programming. Okay, in the last classes we already saw functional programming in the JavaScript. Okay, so what is the use of that functional programming? In that classes we already discussed that code reusability, right? Debugging is easy, packaging, code maintenance is easy, like that. So what is OOP means? Object oriented programming. That means it is not functional oriented, a functional oriented advanced, okay, object oriented programming. So the name itself indicating that the programming methodology is based on the objects. So now what is object, what is method? Class we will learn those terminologies. First let me define what is OOP. The object oriented programming is a programming paradigm based on the concept of objects, okay, which can contain data in the form of attributes or properties and functionality in the form of methods that are planned and designed using classes or class keywords, right? So simple friends, object oriented programming is a one type of procedure of programming. So in that procedure we are making use of objects, okay. In functional oriented programming, what we did, we make use of functions, right? And then when come to object oriented programming, we will make use of objects for programming, okay. So let us see what object is, what attribute, what is method, what is class. We will learn all these things step by step. In my Python tutorials I had given the same example. So if you want it to be in Telugu, please refer back my Python OOP classes. Now let me discuss the underlying principle of object oriented programming. Say if you want to design a car like this, okay, like this, what you do first, what the manufacturers will do first. So the manufacturing units, let say, suppose say Maruti Suzuki or Honda or Benz or BMW or any car it may be. So before the car, they planned the car structure, okay, where should engine come, where should exhaust come, where should wheels come, okay, where, what is the size of the doors, what is the length and breadth of the car, width of the car, okay. So all these things will be designed by the architects, right, engineers, okay. And then what they will do, so after they had planned, they will keep that plan or the blueprint or anything you may call, it's a blueprint or plan or model, like that, okay. So based on this model, based on this blueprint, whatever word you may call, okay, so they, those people make this a reference, right, to create a original car, right? So this car plan, structure, everything will be available in this figure, that is called blueprint, famously call it as blueprint, right? Or in general terms, a model, or even generally it is called plan. Okay, so according to this blueprint, the car will be created in the manufacturing industry. Okay, now what this car have? So at the time of design itself, they will be some properties. Okay, what is the car color, what is the wheels, what is the fuel type, all those will be designed here, right? And then at the time of designing itself, what should be the functioning of the designed car, moving from place to place, whether the audio setup is included or not for playing music, whether the video setup is there or not for playing movie, all these things are taken care of in the class at the time of designing itself. After designing in the car, that blueprint, these, by following this blueprint, and car will be created, right? So a created car will have the properties like the color, wheels, fuel. So at the time of designing itself, we had planned this one, and then methods like and functions, methods or functions, both are same. So these are the little functions, right? So these are all designed at the time of designing phase itself, and then by following this plan, the car will be created. Got the concept? First you need to understand this example, okay, for better understood the programming methodology. I am going to relate this car design example with OOP. Okay, now so let's analyze this. So our class, okay, the class means the design part, just remember that. Class means we are going to design one program, okay, by taking a paper and pen. We are going to design so and so, so and so, so and so, what are the variables, what methods or what functions this class will have, all those things will be designed here, okay. And then based on the need, we will create the object out of this class design, which we are written the code. If you return the code for 100 lines of code will be returned for this class, then this 100 lines of code as a reference, it will act as a reference, and this code you will reuse, okay, reuse for your purposes, okay. That means instantiation, that is called instantiation. This is the your reference code, prototype code, right? So for that code will be utilized as an object, okay, and you can modify that code according to your interest. If you want the color to be white color for the same plan, white color, then you take this plan and just change the color property to white. So remaining the structure, everything is same, okay, white car will come, right? Similarly, so this 100 lines of code was already written and made available, okay, for you, okay. So you no need to sit and develop all the code again for a specific functionality. Some functionalities are already inbuiltly defined in the form of classes. So what they will do is they do this thing only, they design everything and make available to you. What your job is, just use that code. How to use that code means objectified, that means instantiate, that means you are borrowing this code, and the borrowed code is called an object. Then that object you can modify that code according to your own interest. See, if you don't want the color to be gray and if you want your color to be some red, then you can implement your own color is equal to red. So that option will be provided in the design itself. Okay, if you change that color, okay, your object, required object will come like that. Okay, right? So the basic thought, the idea is one reference will be developed. By making that reference, you will be developed some object out of it with your own properties and methods, right? Values. Okay, that is the concept of object oriented programming, friends. Okay, so in the next class we will discuss the next topic of OOPS terminology. Okay, so till then, bye bye. Your Svira signing off. Thank you for listening, friends.